As you're sitting amongst the rest of the glorious cast of It, why do you think that film has become so beloved and such a timeless classic?
I think It has kind of lasted as a classic because it speaks to what the experience of childhood is for a lot of people, which is we all feel like we're outsiders, or some of us like kind of are losers, right? So yeah, I think the idea of like belonging and friendship that the film portrays is, yeah, I think it speaks to people.
Can you talk a little bit about your experiences on set and the ones that make you smile the most when you think about them on days like today?
There was a lot of teasing that went on set because I was the only girl, so all the boys were like really into video games, and at that time, like, girls didn't really play video games, but I wanted to like prove that I could do it. So I one day like got one of them to like lend me their Game Boy, and I was just miserable. Like, I failed miserably, and they were all kind of like, yeah, we knew you would fail because you're a girl. But like, so yeah, it was kind of like that. It was a lot of teasing.
You're working with an absolute genius in Tim Curry. Can you talk about what that experience was like for you and why the character has become so iconic, you think?
Yeah, working with Tim Curry was great. Like, he was a real method actor, so he wasn't very friendly with the kids. He just kind of sat in his cast chair chain smoking, and when the kids would walk by, he would kind of leer at us so that we would genuinely fear him. And yeah, we did. He was a bit of a creep. He's kind of creepy. And I think Pennywise the clown, yeah, I think he's scary because, again, like, he just speaks to childhood. Like, childhood is supposed to be this, like, fun thing. It's constructed as this, like, it's idealized by our culture, and it's not reality for most people. And I think that's kind of what the clown represents. It's, like, it's supposed to be fun and cheerful, but, you know, of course, like, reality is that a lot of us are marginalized for whatever aspect of our identity doesn't fit into the mainstream. And yeah, childhood can be a scary time. It's a very vulnerable time.
I'm curious if you've seen the more recent big screen version of It and how you felt that version compared to yours, if you have.
I haven't actually had a chance to see it yet because I have kids. So I've just been watching, you know, kids movies. Haven't had a chance to actually get out and see a horror movie for quite a while. So maybe when they're a bit older.
Curious what you think the horror genre has that creates this devotion amongst fans. Why are people so passionate about horror?
I think the things that scare us, like, they just go to a very deep level of what makes us human. And so there's, yeah, like, lots of layers to a horror film. There's always an element of, like, what threatens society, what threatens culture, and it's also cathartic watching a horror film. So it's kind of a chance to, like, release your whatever dread and tension, anxiety you carry with you, like, on a day-to-day basis. You watch a horror film and you have that feeling of, like, being terrified, and then you can relax because it was just a movie.
Another film that you're involved with that means so much to so many fans is Ginger Snaps. Can you talk a little bit about why that, again, has such a very special place in fans' hearts?
I think Ginger Snaps, it was just a really, at the time, it was a really unusual, kind of unique film with, like, unique characters. Like, Bridget is not, like, your typical pretty teenage girl. Like, she's kind of weird, and so that was really fun for me to get to construct a character like that. And yeah, a lot of people have told me that, like, that's what they were like when they were young too, and it's just nice to see, like, alternative characters represented on screen.
I think obviously horror is often described as a male-centered genre, but I think films like Ginger Snap seem to definitely go against that trend. Do you think that's part of why people latch onto it, and it means so much to so many people?
Yeah, I think Ginger Snaps was about the female experience, right? And coming of age from a woman's perspective. So, yeah, I think it was a bit of a breath of fresh air at the time.
Have you got a message, I guess, particularly for It fans all around the world who are still terrified and in love with this version of the story you've given them?
Yeah, I guess just thank you very much for connecting with the film, because like as a kid, like I had no idea that people would actually connect with it. Like when you're filming, you have like lots of people around, so it's really hard to see the story as a whole, and it's just so meaningful for me to feel like I helped tell a story that connected with so many people. It's really a rewarding kind of feeling.